Hello, and thank you for inviting me. This work is a collaboration between MILA, Quebec Institute of Artificial Intelligence, and University of Oslo. What we are going to see is ways to use machine learning, and in particular reinforcement learning, to develop and soft and test web applications. The main point is deep learning has been going through an exponential growth in terms of compute, in terms of the models, size of parameters. And like in the last few years, we have seen doubling in performance in computation every few months rather than every year, few years. And the algorithms keep the pace. Like we can scale the algorithms up to the compute that we can throw at it, and we can throw a lot of compute to the problems. So the question we have been asking is, can we formulate the testing problem security as a reinforcement learning problem where there is a client, the attacker or the tester, and an environment which will be the web server. The client sends a request, which in terms of reinforcement learning, it's called an action. And the web server returns to the client a state or observation and a reward. The state will be the HTTP response, while the reward will be whether the task was successful or not yet. So an action looks like the second line, like a GET request, HTTP request, with some payload, which could be URL, some data to send over. And this payload can either be encoded, like we can predefine some alternative templates, or we can have a dictionary, like a set of words that have to be composed, or characters, or ideally it would be row byte stream. The observation of space coming back from the environment to the agent, it's more generally an HTTP response with some HTML inside, optional. And deep reinforcement learning instead is when we put together the reinforcement learning framework and machine deep networks. Currently, user research is done in robotics where we have simulators that work at the speed of 100 simulation steps per second. Let's not define what it is in general, how many interaction we can have with the environment. The best we can have so far is 10,000 steps. And this is on specialized hardware, on very specialized architectures. While web servers themselves, they're made to have a much higher load. In this example, the bottleneck is this SQL server, and optimized SQL servers can go up to 1.2 million requests per second, which is crazy thinking about the speed in terms of user machine learning simulator and reinforcement learning simulators. And a normal web server speed is on the order of 5,000 requests per second. This is crucial because the deep reinforcement learning requires a lot of interactions, a lot of requests before we can get good results. So in our nowhere in this work, we try to understand can a reinforcement learning agent find a vulnerability or some flag within a database? The database is an in-memory database. The agent has the ability to send some query, get queries, and gets the some simulation of our page. To be more specific, there are two database schemas. One with user information, which is the working table, which is where the clients are supposed to be working on. And another one, it could be a private table, which has to be accessed through a union, which contains private information. The task changes at every interaction, which means every time the agent sees a new enhance sequence of interactions, sees a new web page, let's say. Like the kind of query that runs in the backend changes every time the agent, every once in a while, which means that we don't just have one agent for one page, but we have an agent which has to generalize across many different tasks. For example, here in the bottom, you can see the different possible queries. Those would be like select with a different number of columns, and then a different parameter depending on the task. So the first time could be two columns, and first name, which is escaped by double quotes. Second time could be five columns and single quotes. The first approach we tried was to add as much structure as we could inside the agent itself, which means providing the agent with 25 levers, actions that he can pull to try to exploit the current task. Six of them, and also nine of them, 15 in total, are about reconnaissance, figuring out what is the kind of escape necessary, and figuring out what kind of number of columns are present. And nine of them are used for exploitation. So ideally, in our mind, at first, the agent will try to figure out what kind of environment is running in the backend, and then exploit it. The other one is just an empty action for sending. The kind of response the agent gets from the environment is, in this structured first approach, is already parsed. It encodes information about the previous queries and about the response of the current query. So on the bottom, you can see a first action will create an observation of 2111, and so on, which indicates that we did an action number, the action number 0 at one time, and no options for the rest of the options. And the response will be no data in this case. But anyway, the key point here is that we try to bake in as much structure from human knowledge. And the performance of the final agent, this is after the training phase. On the right, you can see a plot of 10 different agents. All of them have a confidence interval of 25, 15, and 95 confidence as a not spur. But in general, they solve the task in three queries, which means they skip the reconnaissance phase and go straight for the exploration. This is on average. So it could take more than three tries every time. Instead, during the training, what you see on the plot is the number of queries that the agent takes to find the flag. And as you can see, at 10,000 or 1,000 interactions, it starts to learn something. It starts to be better than random will be 17 in this case. And even then, it's never converging to a deterministic behavior. It's always trying to, there is instability in the training because of the kind of complexity of trying to figure what kind of backend it's on the other side. So that was the structured agent. The positive sides of this approach is that we can encode knowledge directly, and it's much more efficient to sort tasks this way. The negative side is that this agent can only be as good as the knowledge we encode it, and it's unlikely to find something surprising for the programmer. On the other side, the unstructured approach is to define a dictionary of actions from which the agent itself has to put together the tokens, which will be like SQL keywords or a few words, like a word list. And it has to combine all these tokens together in a sentence or something that looks like a sentence. The observation it gets instead are direct from the environment, from the web server. And so an example here would be the select error gets parsed to a single token, like column. But from that, the agent itself has to figure out how to represent syntax error, for example, as a vector as a numerical vector. And these are learned parameter. So I can figure out that syntax error and columns error are closer than invalid query or success query. And all this learning is guided by the success of the agent itself, whether this is useful to achieve the flag or not. So this is an example of queries that come up over time. In the beginning, after 1,000 steps, the queries are pretty much random. Like they use the dictionary, but they don't use it in any meaningful way. All of the queries are syntax errors or random generated garbage. While on the right side, after a bit of training, we can see that the first, second, and third are the first one is a probing action on a single quote escape, a second one on a double quote, and the third one is checking the number of columns. And the fourth is a mistake, while the fifth one is checking whether the escape is an integer. So it's starting to learn something after 16,000 steps. The advantage of this unstructured approach in general is that it does not rely as much on the human knowledge, on the baked-in knowledge that we put. It just relies on the dictionary we define. In this case, compute and not man hours, which means that, as you remember in the first plot, it scales the performance is bound to grow exponentially with the amount of computation we can throw at it. And it can find surprising solutions. I don't have any solution to show, but some of the ways to solve the task were something that we would not have expected ourselves. On the cons, there is the fact that it requires knowledge of natural language processing, security, and reinforcement learning to make everything together. And there are not many ready solutions. It's a young field, and it requires a lot of compute to get good results of. So on a laptop, it would take a while to get some interesting results. So yeah, like the main key point here is why reinforcement learning now for testing. And the environment that we have, that we look at, are computer-based, which means that they are very fast. They are meant to serve millions of requests per second, which is exactly what we need. And in this new way of doing testing, we define how does a solution look like, and we also define how to solve the problem, but not exactly what kind of ifs and switches to select. Those are selected by the neural network to find these algorithms to solve the problems. And yeah, we can really use this exponential explosion of compute that is happening in these days. So these are the contexts, and if there are some questions, I'm here to answer them.
Thank you, Manuel. So any questions? Right, so yeah, I guess people are still shy. Okay, so one question from my side then. So if I got it right, you are basically creating analyzed SQL injections, right? And
yes.
So my question is, how would a company get an advantage of that? Did you create, first of all, is the code publicly available? And can they create
yes, of course.
Automatically running every now and then and just getting alerts when they see something suspicious, or what's the use case behind it? That's what I'm asking.
I imagine that a company could set up a huge setting of, you know, possible, let's say for every web page, there will be a possible task, and throw compute at it and like go to sleep, come back in 1 week and see if the agent figure out a way to break in the system. Like here it's really about throwing compute at the problem and just defining what is the problem formulation, what is the solution, how does a solution look like, and let the algorithms do what they do best, which is to try a lot of solutions. And once these kind of policies are extracted, exploiting the next system will be much, much faster, right? So if I find a vulnerability for one page, finding vulnerability for the next page would be way more simple. So I imagine a company that first trains on a set of common web pages and offers this testing service, right, in this scenario to the public after having trained internally.
Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah, thanks. Any other questions, guys? Okay, otherwise, thanks a lot, Manuel.
Thank you.
Yeah, and then we move on to the next speech. So